These are local university teams who bring all the latest robots and have them on display out on the floor for all our guests to interact with.
At the annual robot block party at the Museum of Science and Industry.
Our Now robot is playing rock, paper, scissors, especially with a lot of our child guests. And the sort of sneaky secret is that our robot is going to cheat.
But the museum is fun. Why would it cheat?
Because research in human-robot interaction, which is what we study, has found that when a robot cheats in a game of rock, paper, scissors, people all of a sudden are trying to figure out, okay, what's happening?
Ah, because these robots are not just for fun. They serve practical purposes.
It's all about how they interact with humans, how they can help humans.
I have to admit, some of these robots appear pretty scary, like a robot dog without a head or an arm without a body. But once you figure out what they are capable of, they're not very scary at all.
My focus is mostly on robotics and childhood education. So when you swipe to the left, it makes one expression and turns to the left.
Kids learn how to write code and see how it relays into action.
This can teach them how to think like a computer while still being very approachable.
This CoachBot swarm can be put to use for building infrastructure or aid in search and rescue. Just like this dog-like quadruped.
They can use it to like move around obstacles.
Robotic arms to help reach where people can't, and one to melt the ice.
It would autonomously move around our patio and spread salt all over the place.
Jen DeSalvo, NBC5 News.